Good morning, Council. I'm against this bill on compassionate grounds. As long as one child is hungry, our life will be filled with anguish and shame. I think what these victims need is to know that they are not alone, that we are not forgetting them, that when their voices are stifled, we shall lend them our voices, and that while freedom, their freedom depends on ours, the quality of our freedom depends on theirs. Internment is not the answer. I am here to lend my voice to these victims, out of sight, out of mind. That is what we are doing to the homeless by placing them in a location that is reminiscent of the internment camps and reservations. This is the 21st century. You would think that we have learned from our lessons and lived history instead of herding people into places they do not want to go. What kind of quality of freedom is that when the homeless who are victims of mental illness, addiction, financial hardness, are handed even more suffering and humiliation? We must take sides. I must speak up for the victims. Silence helps the oppressor, never the victim. Silence encourages the tormentor, never the tormented. Sometimes we must interfere, we must stand up. When human lives and dignity is in danger, when all is in jeopardy, we must speak out. There is so much injustice and suffering crying out for our attention. Victims of hunger, of racism, of political oppression. We did that to the leprosy sufferers on Molokai. We did that to the Japanese during the war. What does it say about our community when we fail to seek the solutions that we promised? Instead, we herd the sick to an out-of-the-way locale where we do not see their suffering. Human suffering occurs when men and women everywhere. Father Damien of Molokai knew this. He ministered to those who were outcast, despite what people said about him or even the danger to his very life. Can you not see the similarities in the situation as outcasts of Molokai? I pray for this council that you will find compassion. We stack so heavily on the disruption side and very little on the compassion side. It looks like this is a done deal. But I pray for this council that we will do what we were supposed to do a long time ago, create more housing, create more programs, put more money into healing our people rather than interning them. With that, God bless you.
Thank you. Thank you, Reverend. Members, any questions for the testifier? No questions. Thank you, sir.